Hey, 友達 Welcome back to the channel with your host, Nicholas Pettis. さあ、今日皆さん、こんにちは。元気ですか？今日も東京ショーやりますよ。こんないっぱいが、この中に入らなきゃいけないんですけど、大丈夫かな、まあ、これだけではないんですけど。I'm supposed to pack my bags and get ready for this trip. And I'm kind of a little bit surprised at the massive amount of things that I actually have to fit into this little bag. I think I'll be okay though.So I have these backpacks here on the back of my jacket. In here goes a hard shell raincoat in case it rains, and a shirt that I can change when I get tired. And also I'm gonna put in the warm one. I'm gonna lay off with a little bit. I'm gonna put one just like a t-shirt that kind of also just wear inside. まあこの後ろにですね、あの自転車のジャケットをまあ着るときですね。まあ交換がしやすいように、まあもし万が一雨が降った場合ね、交換しやすいようにこのバックパックの方にはバックパックというかこのジャージーの中のようにこうやって3つぐらいが後ろにつきますね。なんですぐ取り返すことができる。 Plus also it's gonna save a space inside my bicycle bag which I think is gonna be pretty darn full. そうだね、もう明日から出発なんですよ。I think all the vlogging that I'll be doing on this trip is going to be delayed. But I'm going to try and do some live feed up posts from when we're actually riding. Also maybe in the mornings too. I brought an extra 2 terabytes of database for this trip. So that's going to come in handy. And download that onto the computer and just like transfer it over here so I can keep all the data. And then when I get back from the trip, I'm going to edit it. And hopefully we'll have a lot of beautiful footage and also no rain. まあですね、こうやってあの 2TB の、まあ、ハードディスクを、ポータブルハードディスクを買ってこれを持っていくんですね。で、これはですね、まあ、ブロギングはするんですけど、あれ？あ、これ2つある。面白い。ブロギングするんですけど、まあ、生中継は多分昼の12時ぐらいから1時まで1時間ぐらいが生中継の走る姿を見せたいと思ってるんですけど、まあそれは後ほどまたアップロードするんですけど、全体的なブロギングのストーリーとか、まあ語り合っているところとか、なんか体験しているところがもし何かあれば、私多分ですね、帰ってきてから全てやると思います。So I'm probably gonna do that all when I get back. そのためにその 2TB の、まあ、あのハードディスクの、ポータビルのやつはこう持ってきてるんですね。靴下、まず絶対大事ですね。So you're gonna have to have socks and underwear, obviously. I mean, it's the essential for survival, socks and underwear. Good, they're gonna go down at the bottom here. My pajama is gonna go down in the bottom. Yep. And there's my pajama t-shirt. Here's the tracksuit that I'm gonna be wearing in the evenings. まあ、まず靴下と、まあ、パンツですね、が全部入って、そしてパジャマのやつの、あの短パンと、夜に、着る、トラックスーツですね、みんなご飯で食べるとき。このトラックスーツが必要だな。そして、an optional coat to be wearing on the trip。まあ、オプショナルのコートとしては、あの走りながら、これの代わりに、着るやつですけどね。It's probably instead of this one. This is my hot inner that I actually would like to bring inside with somewhere close. Because if it's cold, I need to get to it really quickly. This is an extra t-shirt, just in case. I got my gloves, they're optional. So I'm going to put them in the bag now.I got my head bandana, it goes in there. And then I'll be wearing this suit and these two. And so, I guess I got everything in the bag. あれ？これこんな簡単に全部入っちゃうんですか？まあ、あとはね、当然、ブロギング用のカメラと、スタンドと、充電器なんですけど、これですね、意外に入りますね、余裕で。Yeah, that's not a problem at all. There's actually still more space in there. I could probably put all the whole stuff in if I wanted to. It's going to be a great trip. This thing sits right at the back of the bicycle. It just clips in and then it just sits there. And yeah, it's so much easier to ride without anything on your back actually. まあこれがですね、自転車の後ろにはこうやって簡単にクリップオンしたんですけど、まあクリップオンしちゃえばもうあの背中に乗せなくて済むから、まあだいぶ楽なんですけどね。いやー本当に明日出発でかなりな心配ですね。いきなり初日ですね、木曜日には、140キロ走ることになりますけど、On the first day we're gonna ride 140 kilometers and it'll be really nerve-wracking、if anything silly happened on that trip. But yeah, I feel confident, because I've been practicing a lot over the last couple of weeks, riding a lot on the bicycle and also just getting equipment and being prepared and stuff like that. まあこの数週間ぐらいですね、かなりのあのボリュームをまあ増やしていっぱいたくさん走ってきたんですけど、ただこれは都内ですね。まあリュックもつけて、リュックつけないで重たいリュックとかいろんな体験をしてきましたけど、まあとにかくその走ることをたくさんやってきた。だいたい20キロ、30キロぐらいが1日やってましたけど、でも20キロ、30キロだと大したことないんですよね。140キロですから。
Yeah, so me talking about preparing and riding around on the bicycle inside Tokyo is like completely ridiculous. It's only like 30, 40 kilometers maximum in a day. And that's nothing compared to 140 kilometers out in the street where the wind is. What if the wind blows in our face the whole way for 140 kilometers? Oh.
そうなんだよね。There is nothing worse.Then, 向かい風、もう本当に、that's that wind that blows right in your face and it just feels like a wall and you have to go through it and you have to crouch down and make yourself small and then just like fight down and bite for it. But doing that for 140 kilometers would definitely not be fun.
まあもしそれで本当に向かい風が半端なかったら、まあやって140キロからずっと向かい風で走んなきゃいけないのはちょっと辛い話ですね。やばいっす。やばいっす。
Not quite sure if you guys can see this. Yeah, there it is. So this bag, like I said,Literally just slides in on the back of the bicycle, just like that.
まあこのバッグですね、本当にこのままでスライドさせるだけなんで、そしてこういうふうにもうつけちゃうんですね。
そうですね、こういう感じにはなります。Yeah, and then I also got a little pack up here which is gonna have the battery and also has like a thing. And I'm supposed to get this iPhone case holder, and I don't think it ever arrived.And that would have been able to attach it in front of it. I'm going to have to think about that for a little bit. See what I'm going to do with that.
まあまあ、それは後ほど考えますけど、一応ですね、まあこういう感じのバッグですね。まあもうちょっと多分物が積めると思います。
So what I'm hoping to get out of the trip this time is literally to just see some beautiful landscapes, see the ocean, feel the wind in my hair, and just that companionship with my girlfriend at the same time, hoping that we can grow our relationship a lot. Meeting the people up in Tohoku is going to be amazing. It's going to be amazing to see what's been going on over the last 10 years. And yeah, meeting locals and everything, just experience the whole trip. It's nothing I've ever done in Japan. I've never really just gone out there and just gone for it. So very excited about this trip. I hope you guys are going to enjoy some of the vlogging from it.
今回はですね、まあ、東北はですね、ね、10年後にはどうなってるんですかね、その美しい国が見たいし、美しいライディングはしたいし、まあ、彼女とも一緒になんかこう、仲良くなるのか、仲悪くなるのかな、ちょっと一つの心配あるんですけど、まあ、頑張って、そうやってね、仲良くしたいと思ってます、2人で力を合わせればどうにかなると思ってますし、そしてね、美味しい食べ物もちょっと楽しみにしてるんですね、まあ、ぜひこの旅には、参加してください、参加してっていうか、いろいろと応援してください。ではIf you like what you see and you see what you like, why don't you subscribe to the channel and set that reminder. This was the Tokyo Show.